So here we have number 11, and the instructions are to solve the system by the substitution method. There's three methods you can always use to solve a system. There's the substitution method, there's graphing, and then there's the addition or elimination method. So here they ask you to use the substitution method, and that's what we're going to do. But even if it wasn't asking you to use the substitution method, it should be clear that you should. And that is because this y is by itself equal to the rest of the equation. And whenever that happens in a system, that's a clear sign to use substitution method, in which we plug in what y is equal to into the other equation for the y that's in there. And then we would solve for the other variable. So let's go ahead and do just that. I'm going to write down my second equation. 2x plus 9y equals negative 8. Now I'm going to write it again, but I'm going to plug in my y with negative 3x plus 13. So that's going to give me 2x plus 9 times negative 3x plus 13 equals negative 8. Now I'm just going to solve for my x. So the first thing I'm going to do is distribute this 9, and that's going to give me 2x minus 27x plus, and then 9 times 13, I'm just going to go ahead and do it on the side here. 9 times 3 is 27, 9 times 1 is 9, plus 2 is 11, so that is 117, and then I'm going to bring down my equals, negative 8. Okay, now I'm going to combine these two like terms. So positive 2x minus 27x is negative 25x. I'm going to bring down my plus 117 and my equals negative 8. Then I'm going to subtract 117 from both sides. That way I can combine my like terms. So I'm left with negative 25x is equal to negative 125. And then since this x is being multiplied to the negative 25, and I want x by itself and positive, I'm going to divide by negative 25 on both sides. So now I have x by itself, and it is equal to negative 125 over negative 25. But I'm going to go ahead and simplify that. So negative 125 over negative 25 simplifies to 5. Okay, now whenever you finish a problem and you get your answer, always look back at the question and make sure that you're answering the question at hand. So even though we got x equals 5, which looks like an answer, it's actually not the complete answer that we're looking for, because we're looking for a solution of the system that we have at hand. So we only have the x value of that solution. So we're going to bring that over here and just write our 5 and then leave space for our y, because we still have to find what y is. So what we're going to do is we are going to take this x equals 5, and now we're going to substitute 5 in 4x in either one of these problems. And it doesn't matter which one, okay? So let's do that in orange. I'm going to pick the first one because it already has the equation set equal to y, so that'll be a little bit easier to just easily find out what y is. So I'm going to write my equation here, y equals negative 3x plus 13. And now I'm going to plug in 5 for x in this equation. So this is going to read y equals negative 3 times 5 plus 13. And now I'm just going to simplify. So this is going to read y equals negative 3 times 5 is negative 15. Bring down my plus 13. And now I'm just going to put together my like terms. Negative 15 and positive 13 is negative 2. So my y is negative 2. So my solution to this system is 5, negative 2, because the value of 5 with the value of negative 2 as your x and y values are the solution for this system.